In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. My brothers and sisters, the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus, the love of God the Father, and the joy and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
With your spirit.
Father John and I are so happy to be with you here today with this video recorded Mass, first being shown on the last official day of school. Although you have been home learning and studying for over 2 months, but we're coming now together to pray and to thank God for the blessings of the school year and asking the Holy Spirit to help us grow and to keep us safe. In 2 days, it will be the Feast of Pentecost, when we celebrate the coming of the Holy Spirit, the fire of God's love and peace planted deep down in our hearts. So let's get ready now to listen to God's word. Let's open our hearts to what Jesus will tell us in the gospel and what Isaiah teaches in our first reading today. For God is very close to us now. Lord Jesus, you are the teacher who shows us the way. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you show us that God's love is within us and that we are to love others. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you sent us the Holy Spirit to be with us always. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, you have filled our hearts with such joy through the light and the love and the peace of the Holy Spirit. Grant that the same Spirit will help us to always grow, deepen our love for you and for each other. Through our Lord Jesus, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. So make yourselves comfortable now wherever you are at home. You can be seated. And we're going to have one of our second graders come forward, Tatum Zemickley, who's going to read to us beautiful words from the prophet Isaiah.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The rain and snow fall from the sky, but they don't return without watering the earth that produces seeds to plant and grain to eat. That's how it is with my words. They don't return to me without doing everything I've sent them to do. The word of the Lord.
Words of life, words of hope, give us strength, help us cope in this world wherever we roam. Ancient words will guide us home. Ancient words ever true, changing me and changing.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Lord.
Jesus went out beside Lake Galilee, where he sat down to teach. Such large crowds gathered around him that he had to sit in a boat, while the other people stood on the shore. Then he taught them many things by using stories. He said, a farmer went out to scatter seed in a field. While the farmer was scattering the seed, some of it fell along the road and was eaten by the birds. Other seeds fell on thin, rocky ground and quickly started growing because the soil was not very deep. But when the sun came up, the plants were scorched and dried up because they did not have enough roots. Some other seeds fell where thorn bushes grew up and choked the plants. But a few seeds did fall on good ground, where the plants produced 100 or 60 or 30 times as much as was scattered. If you have ears, pay attention. The Gospel of the Lord.
Well, it's wonderful to hear Jesus speak to us in the gospel today. Jesus, a great teacher, he always told stories. And so I think in reflecting upon the beautiful words from Scripture, I'm going to ask Tatum to come up here and help me. I'm going to ask her some questions, and we're going to think about what Isaiah the prophet said and what Jesus said. So Tatum, I've known you for a long time. Mm-hmm. I remember you before you were even in preschool. And look at you, how tall you are now. You're a second grader, almost finished with second grade, and you'll be making your first Holy Communion when we're able to do that together. But I haven't seen you for almost 2 months because everybody's had to stay home. And I think in those 2 months, you must have grown another inch. You're taller. And your smile is even brighter. So, is growing up a good thing?
Yes.
It is, okay. And do people ever stop growing?
No.
You have a new baby brother at home, don't you?
A new sister.
Oh, a new sister. You have a sister. And what's her name?
Brielle.
Brielle Lucy?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. And since she's come home, has she gotten a little bit bigger?
Yes.
Oh, yes. And do you help your mom with her?
Yes.
How come babies start so small, and all of a sudden they start to grow and grow, and look at you, how tall you are. Were you a baby once?
Yes.
How does that happen?
I do not know.
I don't know too much either, but that's what Jesus is trying to teach us. And you're holding something in your hand. Can you hold it up to see what, so people can see what it is? What is it that I gave you to hold?
Green bean plants.
Green bean plants to be. There are seeds in there, yes. And I remember 65 years ago when I was in kindergarten, my teacher had a package of green bean seeds like that, and we had little cups, and we had to put dirt in the cups. Did you have to do that in kindergarten?
Yes.
What color was your cup? Do you remember?
It was beige.
Beige, okay. I can't remember the color of the cup I had, but I remember getting some dirt and a cup, and then what did we put in the cup?
We put seeds.
What, was it a bean seed?
I think it was.
A bean seed, yeah, they grow pretty fast. And so is that all you put in the cup?
We put dirt too.
Dirt and what else?
We put water and we put them by the window so they could get.
Okay, you put water and then you put water in it, then you put it by the window so it could give sun. Who gives us the sun and the water?
Jesus.
Jesus, God the Father and Jesus. Yes, our God gives us wonderful things. What makes the seed grow? Do you make it grow?
No.
No, who makes the seed grow?
Jesus.
Yeah, and gives us the sun shining and the water. And when you planted that seed, did it come out of the ground as a bean plant?
Yes.
Isn't that amazing? Did you make that happen?
No.
No, it's something powerful. It's part of the life that God gives every creature. A little bean seed, a little baby sister who's precious, and she'll grow, and someday she'll be big enough to play with you and chase you around. And how wonderful it is that God makes things grow. So when we come to school, and in September, I've been here at St. Joseph's for 17 Septembers, when I come on the first day of school or religious education, and I see the kids come into the hallway and come into school, I'm just amazed, because they've grown more high. Every summer, at least a couple inches. And sometimes, you know, they become stronger. The first graders become second graders. Second graders become third graders. And the eighth graders, well, they don't come back to elementary school because they become high school students. And over these 17 years, I've just watched children grow and grow and grow. And it's wonderful, because that's what God gives us, our life to grow. But you know what's even more special? When you were a preschooler, could you read?
I think so.
Yes, because your mom and dad are teachers and they taught you to read. But I couldn't read when I was in, I didn't go to preschool. I couldn't even read in kindergarten. I just started to read in the middle of first grade. But I think kids today are so smart, and you have so many gifts, and you learn, and by reading you open books, and the boys like to play video games, and they learn even more difficult games, and they can get to higher levels, and all kinds of things, because we grow, because God's given us life, and growth, and a brain, and it's part of God's gifts to us. Now, when you read from the prophet Isaiah, what did the prophet say about the rain and the sunshine? What does that do? It comes down to the earth and
gives the things that we need growth.
Yeah, it gives life and growth to the earth. And Isaiah says, so does God's word come down from the heavens to us and makes us grow. And that's what Jesus was telling the story about in the gospel. He was talking about seeds. Hold those seeds up so they can see. Jesus was talking about seeds and the farmer who plants the seeds. And I remember in kindergarten, when my bean plant got big, I took it home and asked my dad to put it in the garden because we had a little farm. And I watched it grow until we could eat the beans. It was a wonderful thing. But Jesus is not talking about beans. He's talking about God's word and God's love in us, planted in our hearts. And he says, some people, they welcome the word. And God's word makes us grow in love and care. Some people are like hard rocks, and they don't welcome the soil, the seed in the good soil. Some people let birds come and take away the gift, and they fly away, and there's no more seeds and no more growth. But Jesus wasn't talking about planting. He was talking about God's word. The word of God that tells us that we are all God's children. The word of God that tells us that God loves us. And that no matter what happens, that God is always with us. God's word that tells us that we have a job to do in life. Tatum, what's your job to do in life right now?
It's to be a good big sister.
A good big sister? Yes. And what's your job at school?
To be a good learner.
Good learner. And during the summer when there's no school, what's your job?
To be good.
To be good and help, yes. And your mom with the little baby brother, she's going to need some help too. That's wonderful. So God gives us gifts. And are you going to just sit around and eat chocolate all day during the summer and not help?
No.
No, we won't do that. You want to grow. You want to grow up to be a good person, to be a grown-up yourself someday, and be coming to the altar for your first communion pretty soon. You receive Jesus, the bread of life. And that love of Jesus is planted in us when we receive him. And Jesus wants us to grow, to be loving, and to trust him. You know, that seed, when we welcome it, reminds us that God's love, God's help, God's protection is always with us. And we shouldn't be afraid. We should trust God. And then we'll grow. And someday, maybe you'll grow so big, you'll become a teacher yourself, like your mom and dad. Or maybe you'll become a mother someday. Or maybe you'll serve God in some way, helping in the church to help people hear the word, as Jesus says at the end of the gospel that Father John read. If you have ears, listen. Listen to the word. Let the sunshine of God's love and the rain cause God's love in you to grow. So Tatum, we're so proud of you, and thank you. And you can give those beans to your Jaja and tell him that Father Mike says he should plant a garden this year, okay? Because okay. We're going to need to eat, okay? Okay, thank you. Watch your step now. Let's all stand up now. And if you're at home, you can remain seated. But you might want to stand, because that's a way of praying and offering our needs and prayers to God, because we know God loves us.
Lord Jesus, we have learned much about you this year, that we may listen carefully to your words and carry the joy of the gospel into our world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray in gratitude for our teachers, both at St. Joseph's School and in our public schools in Lake Orion and Oxford. They have been challenged this year to teach us in new and different ways. May they be richly blessed. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we are also grateful for our parents who have chosen to share with us their strong faith and their commitment to our parish. We ask the blessing and the guidance of our patron, St. Joseph, on them as they care for us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Father Mike and Father John as they leave us. May the light of Christ be their path into the future. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we ask your blessings on those who are sick and on those who care for them. We pray that the Holy Spirit, the great Comforter, will be with them. May the Spirit inspire our doctors and scientists to discover a cure or a vaccine to end the coronavirus pandemic. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for children around the world. May all children have love and safe homes and the promise of a hope-filled future. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving Father, your Son shines upon us through Jesus, your beloved Son that you gave to us, who promised to send the Holy Spirit to be with us, to guide us, to protect us, to help us grow in your love for and love for you and for each other. Hear our needs and prayers. Take care of our grandparents, our moms and dads, our siblings, all those that we love, and send your blessings upon all who turn to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
I say yes, my Lord,
to the one who hears me.
Brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands
for the praise and glory of his name.
For our good and of all his holy church.
Amen. Loving God, you give us gifts of bread and wine, gifts from the earth and the vine to us. We ask you to accept these gifts and make them become the best gift for us, the body and blood of your Son, Jesus. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
We thank you, God our Father. You are the living God. You have called us to share in your life and to be happy with you forever. You raised up Jesus, your Son, the first among us to rise from the dead, and you gave him new life. You have promised to give us new life also, a life that will never end, a life with no more worry or suffering. And so, Father, we gladly thank you with everyone who believes in you. With the saints and the angels, we rejoice and praise you as we sing. Holy, holy, holy. Yes, Lord, you are holy. You are kind to us and to all. For this we thank you. We thank you above all for your Son, Jesus. He brought us the good news of life to be lived with you forever in heaven. He showed us the way to that life, the way of love. He himself has gone that way before us. He now brings us together to one table and asks us to do what he did. Father, we ask you to bless these gifts of bread and wine and make them holy. Change them for us into the body and blood of Jesus Christ, your Son. On the night before Jesus died for us, he had supper for the last time with his disciples. He took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread and gave it to them, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In the same way, he took a cup of wine, he gave you thanks, and handed the cup to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again.
God our Father, we remember with joy all that Jesus did to save us. In this holy sacrifice, which he gave as a gift to his church, we remember his death on the cross and his rising from the dead. Father in heaven, accept us together with your beloved Son. He willingly died for us, but you raised him to new life again. Jesus now lives with you in glory, but he is also here on earth among us. One day he will come in glory, and in his kingdom there will be no more suffering, no more tears, no more sadness. God in heaven, you have called us to receive the body and blood of Jesus at this table and to be filled with the joy of the Holy Spirit. Through this sacred meal, give us strength to please you more and more. Lord our God, remember Francis, our Pope, and Alan, our Bishop, and all other bishops and teachers, our parents, and all who protect us. Fill all Christians with the gladness of Easter. Help us to bring this joy to all who are sorrowful. Bring us all at last together with Mary, the Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her husband, and all the saints to live with you and to be one with Jesus in heaven. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us now pray together the prayer that Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Risen Lord Jesus, you said to your disciples, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Boys and girls and grown-ups at our children's mass, we always take just a few moments after Holy Communion to be very quiet, to place our hands in our laps if we're sitting, to close our eyes, and to be very quietly telling Jesus, who's near us and within us, how much we love him and how thankful we are for his word and for the way he shows us to be holy. So let's quietly tell Jesus how much we love him. Let us pray. Loving Father, may the outpouring of your Holy Spirit fill our hearts with love and make us fruitful in what we say and do, the way we continue to grow in the likeness of your Son, Jesus, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Just by way of announcement, we have two special people here today. They direct our formation programs at St. Joseph's School and in our religious education department. Thank you, Mr. Zemickley, our principal, and for bringing Tatum, your daughter, to help us today. Ms. Oley, thank you so much for all your hard work with the vast amount of catechists who work with you. We have a representative of faculty here, Ms. Lynch, and so we're so grateful to those, all of you, who lead the formation programs here. And I know through this time of pandemic, been working very hard to continue to bring Jesus to your students and other learning. Because Tatum says, we don't stop growing, do we? So we need to grow. I want to thank Leszek Bartkiewicz, our music minister, always leading us, and Susie Fazzini, who's handling the mixer today for us for the sound, Mr. Carl Johnson, who's videoing the program for us today. You know, usually at the ending of the school year, especially for the St. Joseph School students, I promise that they don't have to do homework the next day. But I know that there are things planned over the summertime for you to continue to grow and learn. So as Tatum says, be good students wherever you are this summer. Be safe, help your parents, and continue to grow. Lastly, there's somebody very special here with us, and that's Father John Maxim. He is leaving St. Joseph's after 2 years. He's going to study. He's going to become a student because he's still growing. And he's even older than some of your grandparents, but he's still learning. And I'd hesitate to hand you the microphone, Father John, to say a goodbye to the students. You could just say a few words and, okay.
Thank you, Father Mike. I just wanted to congratulate the St. Joseph class of 2020 and our public school eighth graders in the class of 2020. It's a special time of the year for you and a special time in your life. It's a little unusual because of the pandemic, but that's going to make your class all the more memorable. A special greeting to the eighth graders of St. Joe's who had their class vacation, and not really a vacation, a trip, scheduled for Washington, D.C., and it was canceled, sadly, and I was going to go on that excursion with them. In fact, I spoke this morning to the canonist, the canon lawyer, to the ambassador from the Vatican to the United States. We call him the nuncio this morning, and he was telling me how much he missed being able to meet each of you. But he had good news. Next year, both he and I are going to meet with the class of 2021 in the city of Washington when that class visits our nation's capital. So good luck to the class of 2020. Keep your chin up. And for the class of 2021, our upswinging to be eighth graders now in seventh grade, carry the torch as nobly as the class of 2020 did. Congratulations to you all and to all of the students at St. Joseph's Catholic School. Thank you for putting a smile on my face every day. Always thank your teachers, and more than anything, boys and girls, thank your parents for giving you the wonderful gift of Catholic education. God bless you all. I'm sure we'll meet again.
Thank you, Father John. I knew you'd have a few words to say. And thank you for your service to our parish. I'm going to miss you. Lastly, I have about 30 more days here at St. Joseph, ending 17 years. And I have lots of grandnieces and nephews up in the Traverse City area who keep asking me, Uncle, when are you coming to live up north with the family? And with great-grandma and great-grandpa, who are their 90s now. And so I'm looking forward to that. I'm going to miss St. Joseph so much. So much of my life has been tied to this community. My vocation matured here as a seminarian. I had my first Mass at this altar 43 years ago. And had the very deep privilege of serving with wonderful people in this parish, serving this very vibrant community and the wonderful families. But children, I'm going to miss you too. As Father John says, we're all going to miss you. And keep growing. And please welcome Father Jim, who's going to be the new pastor taking my place, and Father John, who's taking Father John's place. And he'll be newly ordained. He's young, and he's going to be very happy to serve you. So once again, thank you. So let's bow our heads now and pray for God's blessings.
May the Lord bless and keep you. May God let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you and give you his peace. And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit,
come upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended, and I understand is a closing hymn to end the month of May. We're singing a favorite hymn to our Blessed Mother. So go now in the peace and the love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.